So we're going to be doing question number 3, and question number 3 is asking us to solve the absolute value inequality, and other than no solution, use interval notation to express the solution set and graph the solution set on a number line. So when it comes to absolute value inequalities, you want to go ahead and you want to follow the same steps as before. You're going to get your absolute value argument, and you want to isolate that. Since we have this number in the front, we want to go ahead and subtract 8 from both sides, which will leave you with the absolute value of 1 minus x over 2 is greater than or equal to positive 2. Now, since you have an inequality, you need to make sure that when you're setting it to two different solutions, that you flip those signs for each one. So your first expression will become 1 minus x over 2 is greater than or equal to 2, and your second expression will become 1 minus x over 2 is less than or equal to negative 2. And we make that negative because it is an absolute value inequality and we have to make two different arguments. Now you want to solve this like any other linear equation. We're going to solve for x. And the first expression, we're going to isolate it by subtracting 1 from both sides, which will leave you with negative x over 2 is greater than or equal to 1. You multiply both sides by 2 because you want to get rid of the denominator so you can let x be free. And this will become negative x is greater than or equal to positive 2. Now, when you divide by a negative, you have to flip your inequality sign. So when we flip this, it becomes x is less than or equal to negative 2. And that is your first solution. Now that we have our first solution, we're going to go ahead and solve our second expression for our second solution. So we're going to follow the same steps and isolate x. So we're going to subtract 1 from both sides to get you negative x over 2 is less than or equal to negative 3. Now you want to multiply both sides by 2 because, again, you want to get rid of the denominator so you can have x be free. This will get you negative x is less than or equal to negative 6. We need to divide both sides by negative 1 to get rid of the negative in front of the x. You're going to flip this inequality sign, and x will become x is greater than or equal to positive 6. So now that we have both of our solutions, we're going to go ahead and plug each one of them back into the original equation to make sure that they do equal what we need them to equal. So in this case, we're going to start with x is less than or equal to negative 2. We're going to take any number that's less than or equal to negative 2. We're going to plug it into the solution. So in this case, I'm just going to go ahead and stick with negative 2. We're going to plug that in. So 8 plus the absolute value of 1 minus negative 2 over 2 is greater than or equal to positive 10. So when you get this, so we're going to go ahead and simplify this down, and you're going to get 8 plus the absolute value of 1 minus negative 1 is greater than or equal to positive 10. So when you further simplify the absolute value, it's going to be the absolute value of 8 plus negative times, and negative becomes a positive, so 1 plus 1 is greater than or equal to 10. 8 plus the absolute value of 2, which becomes 2, is greater than or equal to 10. This becomes 10 is greater than or equal to 10. Since we have that equal then at the bottom, this is equal to 10, so this solution checks out. X is less than or equal to negative 2 is a solution set. So now that we've solved for our first solution and we already went ahead and checked it by plugging it back into the equation and making sure everything checks out, we're going to go ahead and check the second solution, which is x is greater than or equal to 6. So we're going to plug 6 back into the original equation, which is going to be 8 plus the absolute value of 1 minus 6 over 2. It's greater than or equal to 10. And then we're going to go ahead and 8 reduce the inside of the absolute value, which will become 1 minus 3, because 2 can go into 6 3 times and into itself once. It's greater than or equal to 10. And this is going to become 8 plus the absolute value of negative 2, greater than or equal to 10. and the absolute value of 2, negative 2, is positive 2. So this will become greater than or equal to 10. And again, with that equal then, this is a true statement. So both of these solutions are correct. All right, so now that we have both of our solutions and we've checked them to make sure that they are true solutions, we're going to go ahead and graph these on the number line and write them in interval notation. So to set these up, we're going to draw a number line out, and this is going to be negative infinity. This will be positive infinity. Let's go ahead and put our solutions on the line. Negative 2. We'll make that little guy 0 right there. And this will be positive 6. Now, since x is less than or equal to negative 2, this will be a bracket. And since it's less than, that is going to represent every number less than negative 2. So we're going to shade in that region. Now, for positive 6, it's saying that x is greater than or equal to positive 6. So because of that equals 2 sign again, we're going to make this guy a bracket. And since everything is greater than it, we're going to make it everything up to positive infinity. Now when you write this in interval notation, you're going to want to include those brackets. So this is negative infinity is up to everything to negative 2 bracket. And then make sure you put that union because you are including your second solution set, which is bracket 6, everything to positive infinity. And we put the parentheses next to the infinities because it goes on and your final answer.